Hello everyone, this is GospelEXE and welcome back to Let's Play Phantasy Star Online! At last, we're getting onto the gameplay! So let's select single mode and let's select our new character, Flayed. Now there is episode 1 and episode 2. Obviously, this is the way for the first time PSO player. And episode 2 is after episode 1. However, since we're beginners and we can't really tackle on episode 2, we'll start with episode 1. We can move around. And you can do this with your analog stick, your C stick, your control pad, and the other buttons don't really do too much. And we start off with the principal right here, as soon as we finish saving. Are you Flayed, the hunter? I'm Principal Tyrell. We have a bad situation. We need to act up quickly. Did you hear about the explosion on our Gulf? Very well. Pay attention and listen to me. We've lost contact with Pioneer 1. We have no idea what has happened. We've sent unmanned search units, but communication seems to cut off near the surface. What happened on Regal? What occurred on Pioneer 2? Are the people on board alive? The console made such a decision to send a manned team search. Or search team. You are a skilled hunter. We need your help. We have no choice. We need a place to settle on. Could you? No, it's nothing. Take care and good luck. So, the world's in danger. Oh no. Since we have a little chat log here. And we have your item pack, equipment, items, and as I mentioned before, you have your mag. You can feed your mag some items, and I'll go into that detail later. Customize, you can set your keys to whatever you want. Personally, I like the heavy attack on the B button, and normal attack is on A. And for special occasions, there's the special attack, which I'll explain in future episodes, since we don't have any special equipment that has special abilities. Okay, so there's my equipment. I'll just take some time to go over some items. We have a simple saber, that's your weapon, your starting weapon for a hunter, and everyone starts with a frame and a mag. Also, 4 monomates and 4 monofluids. Now, monomates, they heal depending on the difficulty you are on, and same thing with monofluids. These also applies to different healing items such as dimates and dye fluids. Oh yes, and you start with 300 meseta, which is the currency used on Pioneer 2. Now here's your technique list. Okay, so Humars here can learn all simple and normal attacks. However, they have a restriction on hard attacks, and they cannot learn Grants and Megat. Now for healing, they cannot learn Reverser, sadly. That's the one that revives your party members. And for supportive, they have a restriction on Shifted and the Band, which are, again, useful techniques, but they just can't use them. And guess what? There's even further restriction. For all these techniques that I did not mention, they can only go up to level 15, with the exception of Anti, because that only goes to level 7 in the GameCube, and Humors can only go up to level 5, actually. So we'll start up with getting some items, we'll prep up. Now, personally, I like to just buy, we'll say, 3 monomates. That should actually last you a while. However, if you are feeling absolutely paranoid, then go ahead buy up to 10 monomates. Being me, I'm actually experienced in this game, so I know what I'm doing. At least I hope so. Oh yes, I should actually go back and actually demonstrate you some things. Obviously, this is the principal's office, which I came from. And this is the check room, aka your storage. Now, here you can store up to 1 shy of a million meseta. And you can store up to 200 items in the storage. And so, this is especially great if you have a lot of rare items you have found in your journey, which I guarantee you will find. And, lots of items, lots of grinders, materials, etc. And starting from the left, we have the Techer Center. In this game, you'll find different items. They are often in blue text, and they are either unknown items on weapons, or they are special weapons, actually. Again, these are in blue text, they are unknown, and sometimes you can get different abilities. There's also this technique called teching, as people refer to. Pretty much if there is a percentage by default on a weapon, then you can increase or decrease that percentage by 10%, along with all the other statistics. I'm sorry. Now, like, say if you have 15 native and 15 altar beasts, then you can get that either down to 5% each or 25% each. So go for the 25. It costs 100 each round. I know that sounds like a lot right now, but trust me, you'll get a lot of money. Here we have the weapon shop. Obviously, your great weapons. Okay, first I want to point out some of the basic keys here. These are your statistics that they increase in. The ones that increase are in orange text, and the ones that decrease are in blue text. Again, as I mentioned, for percentages to your attributes, these can deal a little more damage to your enemies. However, if they are in white text, then there's nothing special about it. Okay, the ones in gray text you cannot equip for now. The ones in green text, they do have a special attribute boost. And if there is something like this that has gray text and an X right to the left, that means you can't equip it at all. Your class is not capable of equipping the item. Okay, so you can see that there is a requirement of 65 attack power for a dagger. However, we only have 45, as we see in the parentheses. However, for some items require attack accuracy, like these ranged weapons here. We need 68, and we have 68, so that works out. However, I'm not going to buy one because, first off, I can't afford one, and we'll find a lot. Okay, moving on, because we're a little short on time. Obviously, item shop, you've seen this here. You can buy different items. Moon Atomizer, it's just a revival item. Antidote, do I have to say? Anti-paralysis removes paralysis. Telepipe is a little tube. You can return to your city. Really useful if you're full on items. And Trap Vision obviously reveals traps. And these are all techniques which I'll go over later on. And if you need some armor or units, which I really doubt you'll need, then you can come here. And these armors can also come with slots. These slots are required in order to equip a unit. Now, each armor can have up to 4 slots, so keep that in mind. You cannot have 5, 6, or anything. Otherwise, this game would be rather easy, if you ask me. So, yes, we don't have too much here. Oh, yes, and we have barrier shields. Those are a completely different type of item. Okay. And let's continue on with the tour. You can talk to these NPCs if you wish, but that I would not recommend. And here is the Pioneer 2 Hospital with all the hot chicks. Now, you can come here to heal up and restore traps if you're an android. This is really useful. However, if you do restore, keep in mind that not only do you cure your debuffs, but you also lose your shift and band buffs. So, keep that in mind. Also, if you die, you end up in here. So, let's just pretend I died, huh? And here we have the exit to Pioneer 2. Our first area is Forest 1, however, I'm not gonna do that yet. And here is the Hunter's Guild, in which you can get many side quests for you to do. If you're new to the game, then there's a few quests you can do. It's basically just tutorials, and really great for beginners. So if you're new to the game, go ahead and do that. You'll need it. It's some free experience. Okay, and yes, that's pretty much Pioneer 2. It's very basic, fairly small place. Let's see, I don't think I need to do anything. So I will stop here, and in the next episode, I will meet you in the Hunter Skills. So, since this is basically a tutorial episode, I will be doing one episode of the actual gameplay. So I'll continue this on the next episode of Let's Play Phantasy Star Online. This is GospelExe, signing out. Have a good day.